From thousands of hopefuls, we are down to just 21.
And tonight, they're getting a superstar makeover and they'll fight for a spot in the top 12.
Prepare for epic performances and serious glow-ups. Welcome to a massive transformation week. This is
Australian Idol! Tonight, our singers will deliver their most important performance of the competition so far in front of our biggest Idol audience ever.
Wow! They are each getting an incredible makeover and choosing a song to show the judges why they are the total package and worthy of a place in the top 12.
Deciding their fate tonight are the biggest names in the biz. It is your Australian Idol judges!
You look gorgeous tonight.
Thank you.
Welcome, welcome, welcome. So, this is how it works. Seven singers will perform, then the judges will decide which four deserve to go through to next week's all-important live shows. But there's a twist.
Always a twist. Now, if a judge is blown away by a particular performer, they can fast pass them directly into the top 12, despite what the other judges may think. Now, there's been a lot of talk about this fast pass, Ricky. I know you want to see it.
Oh my gosh, you better believe I am.
This is what we're on the lookout for. One, two, three, fast pass!
Yeah. How exciting.
Very exciting. Band included.
Nice. Each judge has only one fast pass, which can be used on any singer at any time over the next three nights. Marsha, welcome back.
Hey, Ricky.
Hey, girlfriend. How are you feeling tonight?
I'm feeling very good. I'm excited to see how the kids are sort of shaped up, and and I'm sure they're excited too, so I wish them all the luck.
Absolutely.
Yeah, man.
Now, you've said a few times that the talent this year is next level. Mm-hmm. How hard is it going to be to decide who goes through to the top 12?
I don't think it's going to be easy. Let's just start there. But, you know, like, this is a transformation for these kids, right? And so they've never sung with a band like this or singers like this or an audience like this.
Yeah.
When I say I wish them all the luck, I really do. And, you know, so let's see what they're going to bring to the
table.
So good to have you here, Marsha. Amy, you're looking rocking tonight.
Thank you. You guys look amazing too.
Thank you.
Look like you're straight from the Brady Bunch, don't you?
Thank you.
In the best way possible.
Which part of the screen am I? Tonight we have a lot of performances on this stage. What are you looking for?
Well, I mean, we've said it a million times. It's not just like the voice, it's the package. And this is a real opportunity for everyone to step up and show us their sound and their style and their star quality.
Yeah. Kyle, how much are you looking forward to seeing these transformations? I know you love a glow up, know you love a transformation.
I do. Look, this is where they get to come out and present themselves as the artist they've imagined themselves to be. Now, like, for example, Marsha and I arrived, I was looking quite dusty. Marsha just gets out of the car looking like this, but she was a bit tired, so I showed her the viral Drake video that's going around.
Oh, that woke her up.
That mum is awake. She's ready.
Mum's awake, yeah. Mum is
we'll
awake.
We'll have to catch up on that one after the show. All right, well, should we get into it?
Yes.
Yes.
All right, let's get into it with our first singer of the night. This loving husband and dad of two has absolutely absolutely blown us all away every time he performs. His first audition moved everyone to tears, including Kyle.
I know.
Can Dylan from the Northern Rivers of New South Wales step up and style up to secure a place in the top 12? Let's find out.
That's probably one of the most heartfelt performances I've seen.
I don't usually cry in the presence of other men.
I think you're a freaking superstar.
Whoa. Hello.
Dylan, welcome.
Holy crap.
How cool is this?
Wow.
This must look a little different to your day-to-day.
So different.
During the day, I'm a house painter. My dad was a painter. Both my grandfathers were painters. But music is just, it's really what my passion is.
What song are you doing?
I'm doing Walking in Memphis.
What a great song.
With Top 30 Week, Cole mentioned that I was coasting a bit.
Background music is not where I feel that you should be. I think you're better than that.
So I'm really looking forward to showing what I can offer to kind of get to that next stage of Top 12. I was even thinking of like almost ditching the guitar.
Yeah.
After that slow tempo bit.
Ooh.
It's a massive risk of getting rid of my safety blanket, the guitar, but I need to get out of my comfort zone and really just kind of take it to that next level.
All right, so when you usually perform, what's the vibe?
This is kind of it.
This is it?
This is kind of it. Chill, open shirt, Crocs mainly. This week is about transformation. I'm just ready to transform and be my best. Hello. Hi. I'm gonna get my hair chopped off.
He definitely needs a tidy up.
I think my wife is super nervous about what's gonna happen with this transformation. And I kind of like leaving her in the lurch.
Kind of feel like Chewbacca at the moment. I could just go real drastic and just shave the whole thing.
No! Yeah. Not.
All right, we're just gonna see what happens and I'll see you when it's done.
What I need.
Is that good?
Yeah.
Well. I really got to step it up for this next performance and really hope that the judges see that I'm elevating to be that next Australian Idol.
He stitched the flanny and Crocs, trimmed the mullet and chosen a song of a different style. Will this transformation be enough to impress the judges? Performing the iconic Walking in Memphis from Northern New South Wales, this is Dylan!
Put on my blue suede shoes and I boarded a plane. Touched down in the land of the Delta Blues, in the middle of the pouring rain. Then I was walking in Memphis. I was walking with my feet 10 feet off a beat.
Handsome.
Hello.
Dylan, this
this is wild. You look like a superstar, dude. I'm like so proud of you right now. Like this whole transformation, you have really made it work for yourself, and you kept true to your sound as well. You're still Dylan there, but you look incredible, man. Like really incredible. Which is like a big part of it, you know? Like this whole experience is you need to be able to trust the process and you need to be able to take things to the next level to be the Australian Idol. And I'm just so damn proud of you right now. That was awesome.
Thank you.
It was great to see you walk out and you're comfortable behind the guitar, you know, but you threw that bad boy to your side and you came out and you performed, which is what we were really hoping you would do. And you do look great, like Amy said. Well done, man.
Thank you.
Dylan, everyone's pretty excited about that, man. That was very good. You look great. You always did. You always sounded great. But what I worry about when they go through the transformation stage is sometimes if you're a little shy communicating with new people, you'll be out here in a tutu and gym boots and you're like, I feel uncomfortable. You look comfortable.
Yeah.
You sound great. That's award-winning stuff, man. That's very, very good. You should be happy.
Thank you very much.
Dylan! Our first performer of the night. What a way to kick off the show. Are you relieved? Are you happy that's done?
So happy I was first.
Yeah. How did you feel the performance went?
Good. It's so good with this crowd. It's amazing to be in front of everyone here.
And in the audience tonight is your beautiful wife, Georgia. Hi, Georgia.
Hello.
How do you think he went? What do you think of this transformation? What a hottie.
Oh, I was so nervous. And it looks bloody great, doll.
Thanks,
mom. Amazing.
That was the most Australia answer ever. You look bloody great, Dal. Well, Dylan has set the bar high, but the question remains, will he make it into next week's Top 12 live shows? We'll find out at the end of the show. Make some noise for Dylan!
What a way to kickstart the show. Did you guys love that performance? Keep the energy coming for our next performer. She's the pop R&B singer from Perth, WA, hoping to land herself a spot in the top 12. This is Drea.
She's a performer already.
I feel this aura. You're going to be really hard to beat.
So I'm doing this for baby Drea and all the other little girls who look like me. I just want to let them know that you can do this. It is so possible. Give it your heart, give it your all. You never know where this might take you.
Oh my God.
For Top 21, I'm singing New Rules by Dua Lipa.
Holy smokes.
Hello, hi. How are you? So I have to set myself some new rules.
Okay, rule number one, connect.
For this performance, I'm really focusing on connection with the judges, with the audience, but also with myself. Connecting with the song and the journey that I've been on and trying to portray that to everybody else.
Number two is communicating with the band.
I'm Drea.
Dorian.
Nice to meet you. If there's disconnect in the band, the performance is gonna go astray.
This is a different type of performance, so need to make sure I work the camera.
Can I please speak to Gary, the director?
How are you?
I'm good, thank you. How are you?
Very well.
It's about connecting with the audience at home. Australia, the people who are going to vote for me.
And I can fly the spider cam in around here, bring it around the whole, and that opens up and the whole background now will be 1,200 audience up there.
Okay. So if I stick to these new rules and I execute everything, I'm hoping that the judges will pick me to be part of the top 12.
We're gonna do it. We're gonna do it. It's gonna be fun. It's gonna be great. Yeah, I've got my three rules. Here we go.
She transformed and crafted every moment of this performance in a bid to make the Idol top 12. Singing Dua Lipa's new rules. A global hit with over 2 billion streams. Representing WA. This is Drea.
sleeping, now I'm making myself crazy. Out of my mind, wrote it down and read it out, hoping it would save me. Too many times, yeah. Pick up the phone, you know he's only calling cause he's drunk and alone. Too. Don't let him in, you'll have to kick him out again. Three, don't be his friend, you know you're gonna wake up in his bed in the morning. And if you're under him, you ain't getting over him. I got no rules, I count time.
Wow, look at you.
Thank you.
Man, that was great.
Thank you.
You know what I like about you? You know how to sing. You remind me of, like, when I first met Rihanna, she didn't realise how good she was and obviously didn't realise how fast she was going to go. You're very different vocalist to her, but it's that same sort of, you just don't realise how good you are and you move really well. You didn't sacrifice the vocal for over moving. I just thought it was, I really felt like I was watching a real deal, a well-established artist.
Thank you, Kyle.
Yeah, I agree, Kyle. I think you're so professional, Drea. Like, I honestly, and I think I said this when I met you, is I really don't feel any nerves, like, when I watch you. I just feel like I'm enjoying the Drea show, you know? Yeah. It's fantastic. And the rules that you set was really cool to see because a lot of people don't see the work that goes in behind an artist's performance, and I think that's a real key aspect of really taking it to a new level, because this just doesn't happen. You need to set those rules and you really need to follow through, and you did that tonight.
Thank you so much, Amy.
What I really dug, girlfriend, walk that walk, okay? You walked out here like you own that stage and you did a great job.
Thank you, Marsha.
You're welcome, honey. You're welcome. And look, you know, and you did what you said you'd do, and that's very important. And Amy knows, in performance, if you set yourself a goal, you have to do it, and you did a great job.
Thank you so much, you guys. Oh, my gosh. Are we twinning right now? Oh, my goodness. Nicely done. Drea. Oh, what a way to own that stage. How do you think you went?
Really well. I really enjoyed that. Been waiting for this moment to get out in front of the crowd, and you guys are amazing. So electric. So yeah.
How was it performing on this stage in front of this ginormous audience?
Phenomenal.
Yeah.
Oh, I walked out and I was like, oh my days, here we go, here we go. Very fun.
Well, you absolutely ruled that stage, and hopefully it was enough to score a place in the top 12. One more time for Drea. Only four singers from tonight's show will make it through to the top 12. We're going to find out at the end of the show who stays and who goes. But next, he's our heartthrob who first wowed us with his cover of ABBA's Mamma Mia. Ripley is putting his spin on another song, but just you wait until you see who helped him prepare for his performance. A surprise you won't see coming. But first, while our top 21 are hoping to change their lives on the Idol stage, so are five new farmers on Farmer Wants a Wife. They are hoping something magical will happen when they find real love. Let's take a look at the brand new season.
This is not made up. From the moment they meet, whatever happens, happens.
It's an intimidating feeling, meeting a beautiful woman. Got me lost for words.
Five five new farmers will put their heart in the hands of a stranger.
What's the dating scene like in Pondo?
yeah, dismal.
Here's the dream. You're riding off into the sunset with some, for sure.
Obviously, I want to kiss you.
It's beautiful. It's real.
Just be nice to have someone that makes me want to come home.
I do feel very strongly about you and just thought you should know.
Amy Blush.
This is true love at its unpredictable best.
My feelings probably are a bit stronger than I've been letting on.
Love doesn't always come easy.
I received a message.
The best choice for me is just to get away from the farm.
Kelly and I did share a kiss.
And prefer to just, like, never talk to you again.
I think, like, have either of you put in any effort?
We like, all put in effort. You can't say that you're the only one that puts in effort.
I'm not saying I'm the only one.
This is something that has never, ever happened before on Farmer Wants a Wife.
Oh, my God!
I did not think pineapples could ever be that sexy.
From the tropical sunshine of Queensland to the rugged beauty of the Snowy.
Oh, like, I can see a future out here with you.
From their first meeting...
The moment I first saw you, took my breath away.
I'm butterflies.
...to their final heart-pounding decision.
I really want to start a life with you back on the land.
From farm to forever. Real love is... Farmer Wants a Wife.
Week on Idol, where we're turning our singers into superstars. Our next singer, Ripley, went absolutely viral after he auditioned with ABBA's Mamma Mia. His twist on the classic has scored over 10 million views and growing right now. He's a big deal in the Philippines, and you've got artists all over the world covering his cover.
What artists?
Bedroom artists, TikTok artists, but they're still artists.
Aspiring artists.
Kyle, is going viral always a good idea?
Well, it depends if you accidentally send a video you don't mean to send. Right, Amy?
Hey.
Amy's renowned for it. No, look, I think the more eyes you can get on you on whatever platform, whether it's the television shows, social medias, getting out and amongst it.
I can see how that went viral. Yeah. Like, he did a great job of it. Like, it's
many people said it was fantastic.
And and that's the vibe of TikTok. Yeah.
He looks very good, you know?
Yeah, good on him.
And that's the power of this show, Amen. Making stars.
That's right.
Well, this week, Ripley chose a song by UK boy band Take That and was given the opportunity to meet original band member Gary Barlow. Mm. Let's see what went down when they met up. So from Fernvale in Brisbane, this is 19-year-old Ripley.
There's something smoking about you.
Very refreshing to see a gentleman come in here, well presented.
That was just so incredible to witness.
Top 21's cool.
I'm excited.
I'm meeting the Gary Barlow from Take That. Take That are one of the biggest and most successful bands of all time. These guys definitely know what it takes to, you know, be an icon.
Hey, how are you?
Hey, Ripley.
Hi, I'm Gary. Nice Ripley. To meet you.
Hi.
I had the pleasure of watching your audition.
Did you like it?
I absolutely loved it.
Yeah.
You're really talented.
Thank you. Did you like what I did with it?
I absolutely loved what you did
Thank
with
you.
It.
Thank you.
Because you really made it showcase your voice.
So this week, I'm going to be singing, you know, one of your biggest songs, Back for Good.
Wow. And now I've heard you sing, I'm excited to hear it. Absolutely. Should we try a little bit?
2 months ago, I was singing in bars in Brisbane, and now I'm in a recording studio with Gary Barlow. This is actually crazy.
I got your lipstick marks still on your coffee cup. Mm. Oh, yeah.
Gotta fist up your emotion.
Is that the note you were talking about?
Yeah.
Gotta fist up your emotion.
It's hard, isn't it?
You can sing that high, can't you?
What's going on, Ripley?
Too high for me. I didn't hit the notes. I know I can hit the notes, but I didn't.
Just watch your pitch on. Fist of pure emotion.
Been overthinking this song, so yeah, there you go.
You're in your head.
Yeah, I know.
You need to get out of your head now.
I'm pretty hard on myself. I'm not going to accept 70, 80, 90%. I need to give as much as I can give. I just want to do Gary's song justice.
Got your lipstick marks still on your coffee cup. Oh, yeah. Got a fist up your emotion. Got a head, a shot of dreams. I gotta leave it all behind now. You came back for good.
I don't mean to laugh. The only reason I'm laughing, Ripley, is because you can't teach somebody to be as cool as you are. You can't teach them, you know. I don't know what it is, but whatever it is, you've got it in spades, my brother. I don't know what it is.
Thank you.
You're welcome. And you need to know that. Like, even your stance before you walked out. Amy, Ripley, check that out.
Yeah. The arms behind the back.
No, it's good. It's good. Just be yourself.
In all honesty, that stance looks like you're waiting for food in prison. I've seen it. I've got some boys. What up, boys? I know you're watching Idol locked up.
Forget him.
And a couple
him.
More years.
Forget
couple
him.
More years.
But yes, man. And the song choice was great. And I'm glad that Gary and Carmen helped you out. But way to go. Way to go.
Thank you.
Ripley, firstly, congratulations on the mental hype around Mamma Mia. I think it's got like 10 million views or something crazy. And well deserved, man. Really well deserved. All I'm going to say is I'm a fan of yours, but I'm a fan of everyone's. And this is the time where you really, really need to step up. And I felt like it was a little bit pitchy. And I know that you were nervous going into it because of the piece beforehand that we witnessed. But yeah, I felt like it was a little covery, you know? And I'm used to Ripley putting his own spin on things. So I'll just keep in mind, you're great, and I'm a big fan of yours, but this is a very big part of the show, and you can't slip. No,
okay. I agree with what both Marsha and Amy say about the coolness. Like, that is hard. That is, it oozes out of you. It's almost sickening. Very cool. And the vocals, always good. I know, I hear what they hear, but this is what happened. You met Gary Barlow, he's a legend. You guys put it together, you probably compensated because he came up with some ideas and he's Gary Barlow. You don't want to say, no, bro, that sucks. I'm doing this. But you will get there. So this is not your real arrangement. You collaborated with others. Just do you. You know what you do. Don't worry about the others. Just do yourself. You're good.
Thank you.
Nicely done. Going off what Kyle said, how was it working with Gary Barlow?
Yeah, it was nice. It was, like, I had a very clear image and, like, picture of what I wanted to do, you know, with, like, the Mamma Mia. I fully changed it.
Yeah.
I don't know. I felt like this song didn't need to change. So I get what Amy's saying with like kind of sounds a bit covery. I don't know. I just think the song's perfect. So yeah, I didn't feel the need to change it.
What did you guys think? Well, Take That are back in Australia later this year for their This Life tour. Who knows, maybe they'll take you on the road. I might see you there. What an amazing experience. Hopefully tonight you did enough to get through to the top 12. Australian Idol, once more, give it up for Ripley. Each of the judges have one fast pass they can use to instantly send their favourite contestant into the next round. No judge has used theirs yet, but maybe our next contestant will be the first to score one. Up next, she is the Melbourne factory worker with a huge voice that brought Marsha to tears at Top 30 Week. See her get the transformation treatment and perform for a spot in the top 12. Australian Idol is back in a moment. Is 23-year-old Melbourne factory worker with a big belter of a voice. It's Imogen!
I've got the goosebumps. I don't get goosebumps.
You're an awesome voice. That was fantastic. I think we're looking at the next Australian Idol.
Oh, my God.
Getting to top 21, it's like, it's crazy. I walked in that room and I saw pink and I saw glitter and I saw sparkles and I, like, my brain exploded. Gonna make it go. You know, like, I was just working in the factory the other week. I feel like I'm not meant to really be here, but I am. And that's like a crazy feeling to realize that I might actually be worth it. Hello.
Hi, how are you?
I'm so good. How are you?
Good, thank you.
I'm so excited for this kind of transformation. Like, makes me feel like a little bit of a celebrity.
Oh, I love it. It's going to be lots of fun.
I can't believe I'm working with Hailey. She's like worked with some of the greats, like Taylor Swift, Katy Perry, Pink. She's worked with all of them. I feel like a bit like Cinderella, like you're my fairy godmother. Like coming into this, you know, I mean at the factory, like it's not like we're wearing like glitz and glam. Like this is a totally different ball game. I've just come up here from bloody Carrum Downs and now I'm like a little fish in a big pond. For me, it's tricky. Like I'm not exactly sure where I fit in to this whole pop world. And I know I desperately want to. Oh my God! I'm singing From This Moment On by Shania Twain. Shania is like such a big superstar. She's always bringing the looks. I'm really comfortable in like sneakers and sweats and being put in gowns, like they're fun to be in, but I'm a bit stressed about that. I don't want to keep living in a world where I'm constantly doubting myself. That kind of like backseat driver sort of thinking is constantly being like, you're not good enough and you need to keep improving. I have to let that go if I'm going to get far in this competition.
I'm not convinced that you believe it.
Yeah. No, I definitely felt that.
The second you walk on stage, believe it.
Yeah. As a creative, you're constantly trying to strive for the perfect everything. But I'm here to grow as an artist. I'm here to get better. And the only way to do that is to step out of your comfort zone, it's to take risks.
She's a million miles from the factory floor and looking $1 million tonight. At Top 30 Week, she made Marsha cry. Can she impress the judges again? Singing one of the world's greatest love songs by the legendary Shania Twain from Melbourne, Victoria, it's Imogen!
From this moment, life has begun. From this moment, you are the one. Right beside you is where I belong. From this moment, I can't wait to leave.
Imogen, I don't... I'm sort of lost for words. You look... You have arrived. You have absolutely arrived. Not only is that voice just mesmerizing and perfect, you're like elegant and relatable and funny and so meant to be here. That was just incredible. Like, well done.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
When you came out, I looked at Marsha and I thought we might need to put a censor on this show because it was some expletives coming out. I couldn't believe it. Like, seriously. And you know that package that we saw of you at work? You look good with the hairnet on, by the way. I didn't know you until I really saw that because we've only seen you audition. You're a fantastic vocalist. But I like you, you know what I mean? There's something very likeable. And when you come out and do something like that... You show everyone this is a serious contest this year. It's going to be tough. That was fantastic.
Thank you.
Really good.
Thank you. Imogen, you owned that. And that's what it's about. Whoever told you you ain't worth it, they don't know what they're talking about, girlfriend. Tell them to go take a back seat, sit down somewhere. I'm going to tell you something. You owned it. And the audience was mesmerized, as we were. You hit your notes so beautifully, and just the way... Well, I don't know what to say much, except...
Yeah, do it.
Hang on. Can I hear that one more time? I'm going to give you my, you ready? Fast pass! Yes!
Thank you so much!
Yes, that was great! Yes!
Woo! Imogen! Oh my goodness! I had full body chills, I was crying, wasn't that amazing? Oh, Imogen, you have received Marsha's Fast Pass, and you are automatically straight through to the Australian Idol Top 12!
Thank you, everyone!
How does that feel?
I actually have no words. I want to run around and I want to fall down and die. This is incredible.
Please don't do that. Please don't do that. We want to see you sing again.
Yeah.
What would you like to say, Marsha?
I couldn't be more proud of you. You're my own child. Okay?
Oh.
You did a great job. You know, you own it.
Question. Is it a fast pass or a fast
it's
pass?
It's a fast pass.
Yeah, I want to say it like that. I want to say it like that.
We talked about how to pronounce that.
Fast pass.
Fast pass.
Yeah. A fast pass.
Yeah, that's what it is. Own that, honey. Own it. You got
wow.
That.
Man,
excellent.
Yes.
So good. Imogen, I walked down the aisle at my wedding to that song, and I want to go and get married all over again because I want to walk down to that version. That was brilliant. That was amazing. And we can't wait to see you perform again live next week. Head on over and celebrate in the lounge with the other guys. Australia officially in the top 12. It's Imogen!
So far, we've seen Dylan, Drea, Ripley and Imogen perform for the judges. But next, it's Bethany's turn. She's the Melbourne mother who auditioned with an emotional performance for her 10-year-old daughter, Sorelle. Tonight, she's transformed and set to take on a mega Miley Cyrus tune. You don't want to miss this. Idol is back in a moment.
Week on Idol. Now, 21 is a magic number. There's a lucky 21 still left in the competition. It's been 21 years since Australian Idol first hit our screens. And 21 was a memorable year for all of us, right, judges?
Yep. I don't recall what I was doing, in all honesty.
Well,
21, anything could be possible.
I can't remember mine. Much
you can't?
Either.
You can't remember that far back?
For other reasons.
Jesus Christ,
well, star. There's not that much time for Mark to remember.
No, it's
that.
Well, Kyle, up on the screen is you at 21. Ayo!
Wow!
And I thought I'd just become flamboyant, but but no.
King Kyle from
wow.
all the way back then.
Do you always, have any, always
there is
good
so
at,
much going on
always
there.
Always good right? at fashion.
The medallion, you know, the sequence.
Any wow. any fond memories that are maybe PG that you can share with us from this period of time?
I think I was living in Townsville. I'd just started, like, I'd been on radio for a few years yep. and... Yeah, by the look of that, I thought I was really in love with myself. Who wears a cape?
What happens
Who
to your
wears
eye?
A cape?
There's a lot going on
in
there.
Blow
You're really
mesh.
Accessorized, haven't you? Wow. Now, Marsha, you are still 21 in body, mind, and spirit. What were you up to at 21? Oh. Look at you!
Look at the lips.
Yeah, look at the lips.
Anyhow, the black and white colour wasn't even invented.
Look, Marsha, you're like a princess.
What a nice picture. Look, I was in Jesus Christ Superstar. And yeah, they needed a photo shoot, and that was me. And that was my first party, actually, my 21st.
Wow.
My first party ever, yeah.
This photo is from that? The yep. party?
Your yeah. first party ever?
Yeah,
or your
I didn't
first
have a party.
Party.
Look at those eyes. So, nice. So like but crystal clear.
Stunning. Party, stunning. Yeah.
She does look the same.
Exactly the same.
Let's
Amy,
have a look at
I don't know where this is going, Amy, but I really Amy. Don't want my turn.
Well, 21 wasn't that long ago for you. Who do we have in the photo here with you? You look so gorgeous, little baby Amy.
That would be the most, my manager would have dug for that, and that's probably the most PG photo I have from that night with Nanny.
Hi, Nan.
That would have been shot very early in the evening.
Yes.
You know what I love about that? Amy's teeth grew before the rest of her did. She's mainly teeth there.
Yes. Well, we are more than halfway through tonight's show. Loved those photos. Now, with just three of tonight's seven performers left to sing, then we find out who from tonight will make the top 12 and perform at next week's live shows. Will one of them be our young mum from Melbourne? This is Bethany.
Hello, you look beautiful. What are you doing?
I'm having fun like a normal kid.
This journey is really important for myself and my daughter. For the top 21, the song I've chosen is Used to Be Young by Miley Cyrus. The song's about evolution, learning and growing. I can definitely relate that to my life being a young mum and just being a little bit crazy when I was younger and being in a different space now.
How old is your daughter?
10.
She must be so proud of you right now.
Yeah, and she's coming.
Here. So, she's going to be
yeah,
here
she's coming
for
now.
This one?
Yeah.
I was already going to be emotional, and now I'm just, oh.
Love you, have a good day at school. Bye.
I had Sorel when I was 18. It was very, very difficult. Yeah, I was single and doing it by myself, but I had a lot of help from my family and my mum. She was a massive rock to me, up with me at all hours of the morning. I was really unstable in the beginning stages of it, and I've definitely transformed into someone that is loving being a parent now. Probably up until this point, I haven't really sang songs that I can really emotionally connect to.
There was a moment where I was even just practicing, where I was kind of getting emotional. I was like, reel it back.
We don't need you a blubbering this. We don't want you.
We don't want that. Hopefully I keep it together.
I want to do the song justice. It's kind of like an apology song to my family, my mum, and a thank you. As a single mum, I've always had to work twice as hard.
Better get that butt moving.
That drive and determination I'm going to bring to the stage.
Goodbye. I love you.
She's embraced a new level of glamour to add to the total package. Her family, including 10-year-old daughter Sorel, are here cheering her on. Singing one of the biggest hits of last year from Grammy-winning Miley Cyrus, this is Bethany!
Truth is bulletproof, there's no fooling you. I don't dress the same. Me and who you say I was yesterday have gone our separate ways. Left my living fast somewhere in the past, cause that's what chasing cars. Turns out open bars lead to broken hearts and go way too far.
I know I used to be crazy. I know.
'cause I used to be young.
Bethany, nice choice of song. Everyone loves Miley. You do it really well. I thought you might get caught up here because on Transformation Night, we get to see the artist you want to be. You look fantastic. Love the style, the hair. And I thought you did a fantastic job. Everything about it was pretty good. I can't fault it, in all honesty.
Thank you so much.
What do you think, Marshall?
It's a great song, and I think you did a very nice job. My only criticism is watch your articulation, because you're sort of, you know what I'm saying, right? You know you're 100%. Singing in that place where I didn't hear what I needed to hear.
Yeah.
But all in all, I think you did great.
Thank you so much, Martha.
Yeah, Bethany, you look incredible. Like, you look so comfortable out there. And I know for, like, the purpose of this show and to get to know everyone, we kind of label you guys, like, you're from here and Bethany's the single mom and the young mom. And I really hope that, like, I know for me moving forward, I want to see you as Bethany the artist, because you are a real artist. You just shone tonight. So well done.
Thank you. That means a lot. Thank you.
Bethany, singing from the heart and from the soul. Wow, how did that feel?
Oh, I'm glad it's over, but it was so much fun. Yeah.
Now, your daughter, Sorrel, is here tonight. Where are you, gorgeous girl? Hi, Sorrel.
Hi.
What did you think of Mum's performance?
It was amazing.
Wasn't it?
Yeah.
Thank you.
She should go through to the top 12?
Yeah.
Yes.
If anything, I think she should win it.
Oh! You put it all on the line tonight. Let's hope it was enough to get you into the top 12. We will find out at the end of the night, because only three will make it through. Give it up for Bethany.
I love that from Sorrel. Well, the vibe in the studio tonight is electric. You guys having a good time? I'm firing them up. If you want to be here, get your free tickets at australianidol.com.au. Okay, next up, he's the family food truck worker who has struggled with his nerves from the very first day. Will a makeover and performing a Bruno Mars banger be the recipe for a spot in the top 12? See 25-year-old Kobe perform next on Australian Idol. To Australian Idol, where our singers are vying for a spot in the top 12. Then next week, we hand over the reins to you at home to start your voting for your winner. Could our next singer go all the way? It's our family food truck worker. This is Kobe.
You've got a really cool voice.
I really like him.
Yeah, I like him too. It sounds so amazing.
Oh my gosh. I feel so ready for the top 21 for this next performance.
Talk to me about the song.
Yes, so I am doing When I Was Your Man by Bruno Mars.
Mm-hmm.
It's an upbeat funk version. Bruno Mars is one of my inspirations, but he also kind of had the same upbringing as me. We both started in this industry kind of doing Elvis Presley impersonations. Elvis Presley inspires me so much, even to this day. It's just cool that I get to kind of perform and have influences like from both of my heroes. So one of the things that I kind of suffer from a lot is nerves. It just feels like I can't hear myself. I think one of the similarities with me and Elvis Presley is our nerves. And I tend to shake my leg a lot of the time wherever I am. Whereas Elvis, he shook his leg on stage to a point where it became a phenomenon and everyone was obsessed over it. He implemented his nerves into his performance. And he found his way, and I just feel like I need to find mine.
But you just gotta
feel
your nerves. I feel nervous for you, so just...
So if the nerves did get to me, I think it would be the end of my journey here. And I can't let my nerves take over me.
To shake the nerves and leave us all shook up, singing a big Bruno Mars hit that's had billions of streams. He's dialing up his sound, style, and star power to prove he deserves a spot in the top 12. From Melbourne, this is Cody.
Same bed, but it feels just a little bit bigger now. Song on the radio, but it don't sound the same. When our friends talk about you, all it does, it just tears me down. 'Cause my heart breaks a little when I hear your name. It all just sounds like ooh.
Kobe, there's nothing wrong with nerves, nothing. But you have to, don't let your nerves take over from your performance. You've got to learn to meter it. You know what I mean? And you walked out, you're cool. Do not turn to the band, because when you do, you cut out the audience. You know what I mean? So you've got to face forward. You just got to just trust yourself in the performance. You can sing it. So you have to sort of like perform it, okay? That's all I'm gonna say to you, but I think you've got a fine, fine voice, but you don't trust yourself. You just don't, and you've got to learn how to do that, honey.
Yeah, I know what you're saying. When you come out, you think it's a nice thing to do with the band, and it is, mainly after the performance, mm-hmm. But when you're coming out, we're seeing you for the first time, man. It's like eyes on us. And although I really enjoyed it. I love seeing you move, but I could still, even though you had the moves, I could still feel nerves. I could still feel like you had these moves down, but I could still feel them. I could feel them in your vocals. But I see a lot of progress with you, Kobe. Like, I see a lot of progress, and you looked $1 million tonight. Like, I'm still super proud of you. There were just things that took over. I don't know if it was the band, like, I don't know if it was just, I couldn't really hear you. There was just like a lot going on. And I think I just really want to see Kobe. I really want to work you out, you know? Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I like you. I like your person. I like the sound of your voice. But I did not like that at all. I didn't. And I tell you why. I tell you why. Okay, you can boo all you like, your pests. However, you love Bruno Mars. You've said that, right? One of your heroes. So one of my best friends was the first person to sign Bruno Mars, and it took 10 years to get a hit song out of him because he was so good and so clever and so musical, he was showing off to other musicians and didn't make a hit song. So what you just did that was got a song that's supposed to be about a man who's brokenhearted because the person he loves is with someone else. You turned into some jazz spectacular. Okay. The voice is good, but every connection and meaning and the feeling, all wrong.
Okay.
But I still think you could get through, but man, you're just going to have to go with your gut. Just go with your gut. Don't get led down the wrong garden path here. Okay.
May I just say something really quickly? You love Bruno Mars. You loved Elvis Presley. Honey, you're going to walk on that stage. Those are your idols. You better own that stage because those gentlemen did and do, okay? So never apologize. And that was... Okay?
Kobe, some tough but still constructive criticism from the judges. What's going through your mind?
I mean, yeah, I tried my best, and that's the best that's what I can do.
Yeah.
So I just kind of, I just tried to have fun as much as I could.
Yeah.
And yeah, we'll just see what happens.
Did you at least enjoy the performance?
I did. I had a lot of fun.
Yes. He was great, wasn't he? What a voice. Kobe, why do you want to be in the top 12?
This is just such a fun experience, and I do want to do this for the rest of my life, and I just think that this would be an amazing opportunity, but we'll see what happens. But I would love to be here.
I think you deserve to be in the top 12 for sure. What do you think? He's hoping that the judges liked what they saw enough to send you through. Please, everybody, give it up one more time for Kobe.
Yep, the competition is tough. Okay, we've got just one singer left tonight before the judges decide which of them makes the top 12. We first met our next singer last season, but she's returned for a second shot. See Shanae Boucher transform and take to the stage one of the biggest hits of the 90s. Australian Idol will be back in a moment. Transformation Week here on Idol. Tonight, three of your favourites will be going home. We have got just one singer left to perform, Shanae Boucher, and I'm here with her mum, Jenny, right now. Jenny, you must be so proud of Shanae.
I'm over the moon. I couldn't tell you how proud of all the kids, but particularly my daughter.
Yeah, are you going to cheer really loud for her right now?
Oh, for sure. And I wish them all luck. I couldn't think of more worthy contestants. So happy for everybody, but I am backing Shanae.
I want to hear you scream and shout, all right? She's bringing a lot of energy to the stage.
Well, she said that a lot from me, so I expect that she'll probably hear me from the crowd. I'll have a tone that no one forgets, and that'll be her.
I apologise to everyone around here for Jenny screaming in this next song. Shanae has already lived through a dramatic transformation of her very own, so let's see how she drew on that for tonight's performance.
I have given my whole life to this one moment. There's a lot at stake here. I have grit, determination, passion. I don't have quit in me, but I do have change. So I was 17 when I was at the lowest point of my life, weighing in 120 kilos and, you know, size 20 to 22. And I remember crying in the mirror and being like, there's so much more to life. I knew the first thing to feel better was to get healthy. Fitness has taught me many different things. It drove me into a new era of myself. I put almost seven years of hard work every single day, now at the point where I train 11 times a week and lost 50 kilos. Fitness taught me dedication, and I've been able to put that in my music career. I wholeheartedly believe that this is something that I'm meant to do.
Wow. Hello, everyone. How are you going? Band, you did so well last time. Thank you.
For Top 21, I am singing Zombie by the Cranberries. This is a strong song. It's a protest song. And I know as an entertainer that I can put my own touch to it, my own little swagger.
How did that feel?
I could not hear
the timing
in my headphones at all.
It was slightly out.
It's like, yeah.
Look, my performance today did not go as smoothly as I would like it to.
I'm having too much click. Not enough click. Just a little bit more for me.
Ben, can we just have a little bit of a play?
Just took over there. There's so much pressure with only one chance to keep myself afloat in this game.
Let's give it another go because there's an obvious mistake there.
You know, make one little slip and that could cost me this competition.
determined and daring to prove she has what it takes to go all the way. And with proud mum Jenny watching from the audience, let's hear it for Shanae Boucher!
Another heading slowly, child is slowly taken. Violence caused such silence. Who are we mistaken? But you see, it's not me, it's not my family. In your head, in your head, they are fighting with their tanks and their bombs and their bombs and their guns. In your head, in your head, they are crying.
Shanae Boucher, wow. Okay, so firstly, you look incredible.
Thank you.
It was really great to see a bit of your story. Like, you know, we don't really get to know you guys that much, so this is a really important part. I love how dramatic you are. I love your voice. I felt that performance felt like a really big karaoke number. There was just so much going on, and it just felt like someone who's a big Cranberries fan getting up there and giving it their all. I didn't really get to have that connection. I just didn't feel anything. And usually you're kind of quirky enough to do something, but I feel like you were really concentrating on timing, obviously, and your pitch. And your performance, there was just like a lot going on for you. I could just sense that in your head. Was that happening?
I think I was just trying to do my best. And there's a whole different aspect out here, especially when you got such a beautiful crowd. So you're right. Everything you said was exactly right. It's out of my normal zone.
Okay, awesome.
I met the girl that sang that song originally, pint-sized thing, but had this voice of doom, you know? And as you said in your piece, it's a protest song. And I think you should have found some stillness in that. You know, the bouncing's all cool, but should have found some stillness and just sort of like screamed it, the protest that it is. And I heard what Amy heard, and you were relatively pitchy too. You know, I don't know if it's because you're not used to hearing all this, and when you were talking in your piece, you were saying that you couldn't hear yourself, correct? Did you hear yourself okay then?
Much better than I had before, yes.
Okay, cool. All right, well, all
right. Shanae, I actually quite liked it, to tell you the truth.
Thank you, Kyle.
And it was nice to get to know you. It was nice to get to see, you know, things that you went through and feelings, even though when you were at your saddest, you were still 20 kilos lighter than I was, so. Really making me think about things. And I loved it when we first saw you, we thought you were Amish, and now you're like Xena Warrior Princess. Like, that's some sort of transformation. Like, and I liked all the early man stuff because you sort of saw the crowd, and it's very hard not to see those little adoring eyes looking up and want to engage with them. So you see artists do this on stage live, they engage with the audience, but then they're back to the entire arena. So don't lose your focus. But, you know, it's interesting. You're an interesting person. Mm. And I did like it, but I'm not a singer. I'm just someone that buys songs and advises people where they go wrong. But I think you're on the right path.
Thank you very much.
Sinead, how do you feel about what the judges said?
You can only grow from what they say, so yep. I'm going to take it as a positive criticism.
Yep.
And it is what it is.
It is what it is. I like that. Now, you're a personal trainer. How important is it to have a positive mindset, especially through a competition like this?
It does. It takes a lot of pressure that you put on yourself because you want to do the best for Australia and the people that you're performing to, but also supporting yourself with the right people as well.
Yeah. So. Well, and you want to do the best for yourself, right?
Of course.
You want to do the best you can do up here.
Yeah, but my entertainment is your entertainment.
Oh. Sinead, yeah, give it up. Sinead, how bad do you want to be in the Australian Idol Top 12?
Look, I've been... I call music like art, and I've been painting for a very long time, so hopefully I can continue to keep painting great pictures for everyone.
All right, well, it's in the hands of the judges now, and we will find out very soon if you have made it through to the Australian Idol Top 12 live shows. One more time, give it up for Sinead Boucher!
Well done, Sinead. Okay, the performances are done, so the pressure is now on the judges to decide who deserves a place in the Australian Idol Top 12. Tonight, there are four spots up for grabs. Earlier in the show, Imogen was given a fast pass by Judge Marsha, which sent her straight into next week's live shows.
That means there are just three other top 12 spots still up for grabs. Kyle, Marsha and Amy are putting their heads together and they're going to take the break to make up their minds.
Their decisions revealed in a few minutes. Don't go anywhere.
You decide the winner of Australian Idol 2024. They'll earn the winning title, joining the ranks of Idol legends before them. Score a recording contract with Sony Music Entertainment Australia and win an epic $100,000 to supercharge their music career. What an epic prize! Who gets it? You vote. You decide.
It's top 21 week here on Idol. Tonight, the first seven contestants have performed for a shot at making it into next week's live shows. But already, Imogen is sitting over there in the lounge. She was awarded a spot in the top 12 thanks to Marsha's fast pass.
That means only three more contestants can be chosen by the judges to make it through to next week's live shows. Now, in the break, our judges conferred and they have come to a decision.
Kyle, you had a few minutes to discuss with your fellow judges. Are you all aligned on your thinking?
Not with everyone, to be honest, but with this particular person, I feel it's a no-brainer, and anyone watching at home or following this person online, it's no shock. Joining Imogen over there, because she looks lonely in the waiting lounge. It's with pleasure that we put Ripley through to the top.
Oh. Wow! Congratulations!
Woo. Go. Congratulations, Ripley. How are you feeling? You made it to the top 12.
I'm shocked. Thank you. Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Well done, Ripley. You get to sing again next week. Head on over and join Imogen in the lounge.
Woo. Okay, that is two singers into the top 12 and two spots to go. It's a tough decision for the judges tonight. They watched carefully and took it all into account, but unfortunately, not everyone can go through. Marsha, the tough decision is on you. Who is the next judge's pick?
I gotta say, Scott, it's tougher than tough because you all stepped up. Y'all really need to know that, own it, okay? But can only put one person through. And we did deliberate and we talked about it and we did not agree. You guys need to know that, okay? And the person that I've chosen to put through is Dylan.
through to the top 12.
Well done.
How happy are you?
I am pumped. I'm shocked, but wow. Thank you so much.
Dylan, congratulations. You can go celebrate now. You're in our top 12 of Australian Idol. Well done.
Oh. Okay, here we go. The final chance for these four singers. They left their heart and soul on the stage tonight, but did they do enough to win over the judges?
It's been such a massive journey for each and every one of them, but now the moment of truth. Amy, who are the judges sending through to the top 12 live shows?
Like we said, we really didn't agree, especially this group right here was the problem group, because we all really believe that you all have exciting futures, so that's why we butted heads. So whatever happens, we truly do believe in the four of you. But like Marsha said, we can only take one more person through. Wow. So the person that we're taking through to the next round The person we're taking through to the next round is Drea.
Drea! You did it!
Congratulations, Drea. You're in our top 12 of Australian Idol. What does this mean to you?
Oh, it means absolutely everything. Thank you guys so much. Wow.
Congratulations, Drea. What a massive achievement. We look forward to seeing you sing again next week in the top 12.
Thank you, guys. Thank you.
Go and celebrate. So that's the good news, but the bad news means, unfortunately, Shanae, Kobe, and Bethany, your time on Australian Idol ends right here.
It's been so good to meet each and every one of you and hear you all sing, and I'm sure that this is not the last we're going to hear from you. Please give it up one more time for Shanae, Kobe, and Bethany.
Well done, guys. Well, that is it for round one of Top 21 Transformation Week. Tomorrow night, more music and more makeovers with a brand new lineup of contestants vying for a place at the Idol live shows, including Amy Reeves from Broome, WA. Woo-hoo!
Supermarket trolley pusher, Isaac.
Camel farmer, Trent.
Yes, Marsha. Plus, Ivana, Natasha, Jackson, and Gold Coast Beach babe, Sasha.
Who will join our first contestants already confirmed in the top 12? That is Dylan, Ripley, Drea, and Imogen. Find out tomorrow night at 7:30 p.m. right here on 7.
Thank you to our amazing judges, Kyle Sandilands, Marsha Hines, and Amy Shark.
But for now, head over to 7 Plus to binge the new season of Below Deck Down Under.
Oh my God, hurry up, Scott. I want to go watch it right now. Come on, come on, come on. I'm so obsessed with Below Deck. I'm so excited. Bye, everyone.
It's our huge transformation week on Idol, and tonight our singers are all eyeing off a spot in the top 12.
The stakes have never been higher. Brace yourself for some epic performances and mega makeovers. This is Australian Idol!
The second night of Transformation Week, and we've already welcomed Imogen, Dylan, Ripley and Drea into the top 12. And tonight, there's another four spots up for grabs.
Tonight, more singers will step onto this stage with a new song and new look to prove that they should sing again at next week's live shows, where you begin voting for your Australian Idol.
Deciding who gets there are some of the biggest names in the music biz. Please welcome your Australian Idol judges!
Hot crowd tonight!
Still going!
Wow! Good evening, judges!
Hello, hello! Wow!
Our singers have been preparing a playlist of hits from legends like Katy Perry, Aretha Franklin, Bryan Adams, and many more. And after all of tonight's performances, the judges will decide who deserves a spot in the top 12 live shows. And of course, we can't forget about the Fast Pass Scotty!
That is right. If a judge thinks a singer is undeniably belonging into the top 12, they can use a Fast Pass to send them straight there, no matter what the other judges think.
Mm-hmm. Now, last night, Marsha used her one and only Fast Pass for Imogen, and the crowd went wild. Let's take a look.
I'm going to give you my, you ready? Fast Pass!
Moment. Well, Kyle and Amy still have their Fast Pass to use on any singer.
Fast Pass.
At any time in the next two nights. Fast Pass.
Fast Pass. Amy, you still got your Fast Pass.
I've got my Fast Pass.
You've got your Fast Pass. How are you going to know when it's the right time to use it?
Well, firstly, it's going to sound like Fast Pass, which is not as cool. But I think I'm not worried about it, because when it happens, I'm just going to know.
It's gonna feel right.
Yeah, it's just gonna feel good, and I'm just gonna go for it.
Just do it. Yeah. Don't hold back.
No.
And Kyle, as we saw last night, great singers are being sent home. It's not just about their voices. What else do the singers need to bring to the stage tonight?
Look, we are looking for the whole package, so sometimes you can get caught up in how great one performance is, but at this stage, and I'm telling you, everyone's great, they've just got to be everything that we want, because it's going to be such a tough contest this year. And with my Fast Pass, I'm keeping it in the back pocket to maybe, instead of give it to someone that's obviously great, maybe save someone that may have a bit of a bad night.
So, that's a good thought.
Yeah. I don't want my favourites to get flicked out of one mistake.
Okay, well, there you go. Tactics, a little bit of gameplay going on there. Marsha, the judges are responsible for deciding the top 12, yes. And then it's over to Australia to vote. How important is it to make sure the right people go through to the top 12?
Well, first and foremost, it's not really easy. It's very, very difficult, and it pulls at my heartstrings, you know. But when you find people who are as outstanding as Guy Sebastian, Jessica Melboy, Ricky Lee,
thank you.
Okay, you know, then our job here is done. You know, it's so important that we bring this kind of talent to the Australian public, and they get to know them and vote for them.
Yeah. So true. So cool. True.
Yeah. All right, let's get into it. Are you ready?
Yeah.
First up, from a place that's known for its impressive red dirt, beautiful aqua beaches and incredible pearls, and this next singer, because she is a real pearler.
All the way from Broome in WA, it's Amy!
Amy, that was just so incredible. Do it for your dad.
I will be shocked if you are not in the top five.
Being here is so surreal. I grew up in Broome. I'm used to red dirt, not red carpet. Yeah, as a kid, I didn't have access to, you know, this incredible wardrobe and hair and makeup, but I've got all the bells and whistles now, so I feel like I can really step into this diva energy. I learned to sing, like, all the diva classics before I learned my ABCs, you know? My mum wasted no time popping me in front of that karaoke machine. She said, here, this is what you do now. Hi, Mama. I'm going to show people like a different side of me, that I'm not just a karaoke singer. Like, I can do this.
And there is from Broome.
That's it, Ma. That's the one. I'm singing Think by Aretha Franklin. She's a big one. This is my moment.
Everything has been leading to this opportunity.
I have woken up not in a good way at all. My head is sore, my throat is sore, I've got body aches, and I feel a little bit of a fever coming on. I'm not gonna be able to go to my rehearsal. This song is different, this song is big, it's something a little bit out of my comfort zone, it's upbeat, and I am absolutely terrified. The show must go on, I guess. You know, I have to make this happen. That is what a good diva would do.
She's powered through sickness to perform on tonight's Idol stage, channeling one of the most respected divas of all time. She's taking on an Aretha Franklin's Think for a place in the top 12. From Broome, WA, this is Amy!
Are you even the same human being? This is unbelievably at a great level. If I wasn't on this show, I would sign you to a $10 million deal immediately. Like seriously, you were great. You've always been a beautiful girl. The girl from Broome, just out in the wilderness with the dust and all that. And you look like you've been like squeezed into the Hollywood machine and shot out. Yeah. You look fantastic. The song's brilliant. The vocal is excellent. Like, you're ready to go, which is exactly where you need to be. Brilliant.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, Kyle. Thank you.
You're welcome.
You know, you're so right, girlfriend. The show must go on, you know? And you've been sick. I would never have known you've been sick. You look wonderful. You sounded great. And, you know, Aretha, she's hard to touch, okay? The girlfriend is on another sphere of vocals. But you really did that incredible justice. Well done, honey.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, Marsha. Thank you.
Yeah, Amy, that was insane. Like, a lot of the time when people go for the exact arrangement, like, I get worried that it's going to fall into karaoke territory. You just held that with two hands, and we were all just hanging off every word.
You,
like, your voice was up here,
you know?
And the band was down here,
yes.
And you just owned every second of that. You would swear you've been doing this for, like, 20 years. It's crazy.
Yeah.
I'm so proud of you, Sinan.
Thank you so much. Thank you. That really means a lot.
That's how it's done, really.
My goodness, what a way to kick off the show, am I right? Wow. I was actually watching Amy's face during that performance and she was like, how did that feel?
Oh man, it was a lot to kind of, you know, sing through sickness.
I don't know how you did that.
Yeah, I don't know either. I think it's just adrenaline. I think seeing all of you guys out here really helped me. So thank you so much for being here.
You were singing in the heavens for that song, and in the audience tonight you have a huge cheer squad. How amazing does she look? And how amazing did she sound? Yeah. Oh my goodness, is the broom girl on her way to the big time in the top 12? We will find out at the end of the show. Give it up one more time for Amy.
An absolute belter start to the show. How's everyone feeling? Pretty excited. There's some nerves here. Well, this next singer is the camel wrangling cowboy from Emu Park in Queensland. And I've got his dad sitting next to me right now. John, how are you feeling?
Oh, feeling real proud actually. And very excited.
Very excited, very proud. But did you bring the whole town with you? Because there's a lot of you here.
I just about got Yeppoon, Emu Park, Rockhampton, Orange.
Who's Team Trent? Make some noise. Yeah. I can see the cowboy hats and the mullets. We're surrounded.
Oh, yes.
How are your nerves?
Oh, they're all right for an old fella. I'll control them, I hope.
Well, John, hold on to your hat because he's about to join us on stage. He's never sung in an audience this big before, so let's see how prepared he is for tonight's performance.
You're
going to
be a country singer.
It doesn't get any more famous than
Ultimate
Life than that.
Can I get an
amen,
baby?
Put a lot of effort and time into transforming this week.
How to transform in a week.
I'm going to call it the Great Transformation. You get it? Transformation.
All right, so I've got to energise. What are you going to do to become a country music star?
Oh, bugger.
You've got to stay fit. Just tile up. Yeah, geez. Name's Trent, not Dolly Parton.
Just been trying to, transform from Trent Camel Kid on the farm to, Trent the country music superstar.
Here goes nothing.
Howdy, everyone. Holy crap.
Hey, Trent.
Feel like having a cheeky cry. I just can't believe I'm here. Before Idol, it was just me singing to me camels. So to go from that to the big stage and all the audience, it's crazy. I'll be singing Heaven by Bryan Adams.
Can I get my vocals, like, turned down more? That's okay. I feel like I sound nothing to how I actually sound. Yeah, am I singing the right key? Yeah, I just feel like I sound a bit different to than I normally would, and yeah, a little bit nervous. I don't know. I'm just thinking in my head. I don't know if I sound good enough.
You do. As soon as you allow that shadow of doubt to come into your head, you'll jeopardise yourself.
Mm-hmm.
You deserve to be here.
Thanks, mate. This is it. You know, there's no second chances now. It's still or die. Yeah, hopefully don't let everyone down. Worried, but yeah, just want to do everyone proud. And, yeah, just, I don't know, don't stuff it up.
He's transformed his diet and fitness, but he's still sporting his trademark hat. Will this Rockhampton camel farmer prove he's the total package? With an epic support crew watching on and singing a heavenly Brian Adams power ballad, this is Trent.
Oh, thinking ahead our younger years, it was only you and me. We were young and wild and free. Now nothing can take you away from me. We've been down that road before, and that's over now. You keep me coming back for more.
You know, look, you've been interesting from day one, you know, and I gotta say, it's a big song that you chose, and welcome to being a singer. We never hear ourselves the way other people hear us. It's true, you know. You record yourself and think, oh, who's that? So I understand what you were saying during rehearsals with Carmen. Yeah. I totally get what you're saying. And also, you aren't used to performing in front of an audience. I mean, who is, you know?
This is all new.
Yeah, it's all new, but you did a great job, man. You know, you did a great job. Also, you know, just watch yourself, watch your pitch.
Yeah.
Because you'll go into, your voice is relatively high, so don't go too pitchy and don't go too nasally. And that's all I'm going to say. You're definitely my boy crush.
Thank you. Thanks so much.
Yeah, Trent, I agree with Marsha in that it's mesmerizing watching how far you've come. I know you've never done anything like this before, so the fact that you are doing what you're doing is incredible. So to be brutally honest, your vocals are nowhere near, well, up to some of the standard of some of the rest of the contestants.
Yeah.
But what you do have, man, is the riz. Do you know what the riz is? You have got so much charisma, and this show isn't about finding just a really good singer. We want the package, and you, Marsha's right, you're so interesting, man, and I love watching you.
Thanks, Sam.
You're a total vibe. I just really want you to, if you're lucky enough to get through, please keep working on your vocals, because you've got so much going for you, Trent.
Thank you so much.
So much.
Absolutely.
Thanks a lot. Thank you.
According to Facebook, I've already spoken about your package way too much. So, but man, you are a delight. Amy's right. You are not the strongest vocalist here, but there is a lot of international vocalists that have been around for decades doing selling concerts that aren't the world's best vocalists. As a matter of fact, some of the world's best vocalists will never have a record deal because they don't have everything else. You've got everything else, but not the greatest vocalist, but there's still a place for you on the stage. I think you did a pretty good job, man.
Thank you. Should be proud.
Oh, Trent. Thumb hands in your pockets. Marsha was basically just the love heart eye emoji just then. It was just like love hearts pouring out of her eyes while watching you. That was adorable. You did it. You just did that. You just performed in front of the biggest Idol audience ever. How do you feel?
Yeah, good. Obviously, you know, there's always room for improvement, but, you know, from how I started to how I think I'm on the way up, so, yeah, hopefully, I can just keep getting better and, I can get enough to get me through, so.
But, how much do you want to be in the top 12?
Oh, there's a lot of emotion going through me right now. You know, you dream of a kid.
Yeah.
And, you know, to come from the farm to the camels to this, I'm speechless, so.
Hey, can I give you a little note? So my mum's third husband, I know Elizabeth Taylor, right? he put Keith Urban on his first stage up in Caboolture, Bribey Island, somewhere like way back, and I've seen the VHS, and Keith was horrible. Like a little ratty-looking kid, not the greatest, but had a dream.
Yeah.
And look at Keith Urban, one of the greatest there is now. So learn. There's plenty to learn.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Oh, brilliant. Next Australian Idol.
Oh. We love you, Dad. Trent, hopefully you impress the judges enough to make it through to the top 12 tonight. Go and join Amy in the lounge and let's hear it one more time for Trent. Well, tonight the judges must choose to go through to the live shows, and with so many incredible singers still to perform, there are some tough decisions on the way. Up soon is Melbourne tradie Jackson and Gold Coast beach babe Saoirse, but next it's our lady in red, 20-year-old Natasha Rose from Queensland's Burpengary, is ready to make her mark on Transformation Week. Tonight she wants to prove she has the voice to match her striking look when she takes on a Katy Perry classic. Will she step up to the challenge? Find out next on Idol.
Welcome back to Australian Idol. This is Transformation Week. Tonight, the judges will watch everyone's performances and then decide their favourite four who will secure a spot into next week's top 12 live shows. The judges each have one fast pass they may use to instantly send their favourite into the next round. Marsha used her fast pass last night, but that means there's still two more at play. Will it go to our next singer? She's from Queensland, she's 20 years of age. It is Natasha Rose.
He did something that really no one else that really has done today, which is perform.
Being the girl in red is definitely, it's like having a bit of an alter ego. Going onto stage, getting done up, wearing red, it really just brings that sense of confidence. It brings that sense of artistry.
When I perform, I definitely give it my all.
You know, bringing that energy, that pop vibe. But there have been times when my vocals haven't been perfect.
Natasha, you had pitch problems.
Oh my God. I am a ready-made pop star and I am born for this stage. This is massive. But I really need my voice to stand out in this performance. This is so cool. I'm like feeling all the emotions right now.
For my top 21 performance, I'm singing Part of Me by Katy Perry. I want to transform my vocals by stripping back the start of the song, and I'm going to give this performance my absolute all. I really want to show the judges that my vocals can shine. It's just really about making sure that it's as perfect as possible. It's strong vocals with strong movements.
All right, so let's talk about your pitch. This is the part of me. It was kind of all over the place, especially when you start doing it.
Yeah.
That, as soon as you started giving too much energy, is when your pitch just went.
If I don't get my pitch right, like if I don't marry these vocals and this big performance, you know, it could mean that I'm going home.
She's a vision in red and ready to stake her claim in the top 12. Representing Burp and Gary in sunny Queensland, she's singing Katy Perry's Part of Me. It's 20-year-old Natasha.
Days like this, I want to drive away.
Natasha, wow. I really enjoyed that. I think you look great. I think you look like a superstar. The only thing I'm going to say is you have picked the most difficult genre in the world right now. Mm. For some reason, over the last like 10 years, everyone wants to be a pop star. Pop's not a dirty word anymore. It's like the most wanted thing ever. So that's fine, and it's totally doable, but that just means you need to be phenomenal. I don't think your vocals are phenomenal yet, but that doesn't mean that you can't get there. I just see a baby pop star in the making, and it doesn't mean I didn't enjoy it. I just think you have some growing to do.
Totally, thank you.
Let me start by saying you look $1 million. You look wonderful. There's something to be said about a big song, you know, and Carmen spoke to you about your pitch, and you had problems with the big notes, you know, and you have to really study on that. So just find some stillness in your performance. You don't have to move because everybody's just zoned in on you. Don't move. If anything, if you stop moving, people will watch you even more. Yeah? I mean, you got those long appendages and they look great. Just stay within yourself, honey. Okay? And you got to learn to watch your pitch because this is Australian Idol. It's about the singer. So you got to watch your pitch. Okay? That's what I'm going to say.
Thank you.
You're welcome, guys.
Why'd you say not to move? That's the best part about her when she moves around. There's like daddy long legs looking. It's mesmerizing, really. I think you definitely have the ability to do better than that. I think you scared yourself because it's such an important night. It's do or die every time you hit this stage. It's a lot at stake, really, mm-hmm, isn't it? Mm-hmm. So I think maybe you were so nervous about being great, you muted yourself a bit. That's what I think the last time we saw you, you were like full of fire and didn't care. And it was an edge I liked.
Yeah.
Just don't get too safe. I know you've got to think of all these things. It's a nightmare, but just don't lose what we liked in the first place. Fiery, big giraffe looking crazy, beautiful to watch. Yeah. Everything is great to watch. Just, so I do say what Marcia's saying, because she's more worried about the vocal.
Yes, of course. But don't overthink, you know. Like, there's a great saying back in the day I heard about Michael Jackson, and he said, when you're on stage, Don't think, just be. You get me? Okay, that's my bit of advice to you, honey. Just don't think.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Natasha, tough comments from the judges there. How did you feel about your performance?
You know, so much went into this performance. I have an incredible band behind me, you know, stylists, makeup artists. You know, just to be here on the stage, it's like so incredible, and it's a learning experience every time I get up here, so I'm so happy with it.
It's hard because don't think, but you want to take everything on and think about and take on and make sure that you're doing your best when you're up here. I totally understand that it can be confusing and it's tough, but Natasha, you are so close to getting into the Australian Idol Top 12. How much do you want to be in the top 12?
I mean, there's nothing more that I want. You know, being here has been such an incredible opportunity to grow every time, and I, you know, have come with the package as much as I can every time. I love performing. I love, you know, seeing young people that I can inspire and singing for all of you guys.
Okay. We'll give it up one more time for Natasha. He's the supermarket trolley pusher from the south coast of New South Wales. Last time he performed on the Idol stage, he forgot his lyrics. But tonight, he is hoping history doesn't repeat. After the break, Isaac transforms before our eyes. And later, the judges will make the heartbreaking decision on who stays and who goes. You don't want to miss it.
Australian Idol, where our judges are deciding who should sing for your votes at next week's Top 12 live shows. Already safely there are these four: Imogen, Dylan, Ripley and Drea. Drea, how does it feel to know that you're performing next week?
I'm really excited. I'm very, very chuffed, but I'm ready to put in the hard yards and show Australia what I'm made of.
Dylan, it must be nice to know that you can watch tonight and take this all in, but what about the competition? How do you feel about the other singers?
It's tough. They're all such good singers, but they're a good-looking bunch too.
Oh, you've all been styled up. How about the glow-ups of all of you guys?
Good.
It looks amazing. Well, our next singer is a supermarket trolley pusher with a powerful voice, but at top 30 week, he struggled to remember his lyrics and only just made it through this round. Let's see how he's prepared for his comeback from the south coast of New South Wales. It is Birrell Lake's very own Isaac.
That was totally not what I expected.
Man, I'm so excited for you right now.
I kind of think you're one of the best vocalists I've heard for a long time.
Just last week, I was pushing trolleys as my day job, and now I'm looking at the Australian Idol Top 21.
Goosebumps. It's exciting. It's scary.
I'm experiencing things I've never experienced in my life before.
It's gonna be okay.
I've never had makeup on in my life. That was the first.
Have you ever, like, worked on anyone famous or high up there?
You know what? Yes. Back in the day, INXS guys.
INXS, yeah. I love them.
Yeah, they're pretty cool.
Well, I guess if they've had their makeup done, it's all good. Keep it going.
Yeah, my last performance. Got the lyrics.
Are you never smoking herbs and drinking burning liquor? Is you out of...
My heart just... I felt like it stopped. I felt shameful. And one of the worst feelings in my life, to be honest. This week, I'm gonna do everything it takes to not forget the lyrics again. My next song is Say You Won't Let Go by James Arthur. Morning, day and night, this has been my focus. Practice, 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 practice.
Say you won't let go.
I would do anything to just pull it off in this performance tonight.
You made me feel as though.
Got me lyrics and I was like, oh, I just dropped. I didn't even get past the bloody first bit.
There was a line you missed.
I've been practicing and practicing.
Yes.
It's just, you know, my brain. If I overthink it, I need to remember my lyrics. It's not gonna happen again. No. I'm going to do better. I want to get out of that car park.
Holy crackers.
I want to stop pushing trolleys. I'm going to show the judges I'm worth the risk that they took.
Determined to turn his fortune around, refreshing workwear for a brand new look. It's Isaac.
I met you in the dark. You lit me up. You made me feel as though I wasn't up. We danced the night away. We drank too much. I held your hair back when you were throwing up. Then you smiled over my shoulder. For a minute I was stone cold sober. I pulled you closer to my chest. Then you asked me to stay over. I said I already told you. I think that you should get some rest. I knew I loved you then. You'll never know. I played it cool when I was scared of letting go. I knew I needed you, but I never showed. I wanna stay with you until we're gray and old.
How are you going?
Man, I'm great. That was excellent, really.
Thank you, thank you. It's good to be back.
You know, because I love your voice and you've got this gift that I don't even think you really know that you've got a real gift in there. My wife said to me when we were watching some shows back, oh, nice empathy, because I was having a go at you for forgetting and you can only get scolded off your own wife when you're me. So... And then I was watching those packages and I remembered, oh, you and I got something in common, the homelessness. Yeah. Yes. So you were homeless, I was homeless, and I forget sometimes how invisible we want to feel when we're there.
100%. Yeah.
You want to shrink into the smallest thing. You don't want to be noticed. You don't want to speak. You just want to live. You've been fertilized. You're out of that situation. You're here. You've got to take every opportunity because you do have something special and we want to hear what you've got to say. Don't be quiet. Don't be nervous. Just be you because you really have something special, man. And I think you did a great job.
Thank you, Carl. Thank you.
Isaac. Man, I've had like a real soft spot for you from the second we met because... you're an underdog, and I know exactly what that feels like, and I know what it feels like losing lyrics, and to see you shine tonight was just so incredible, and just to know where you've come from, we need to protect people like you. Like, you are such a superstar. I'm just so floored by how you look, how you walked around the stage, how you found the stillness, how you were so confident, and I feel like I want to, like, give you something right now. I've definitely got something I want to give you right now. Isaac, I want to give you my fast pass.
Kyle had me crying now. Amy's got me crying. This is amazing. Isaac, you just received Amy's fast pass, which means you are straight through to the top 12, my friend.
so much, guys. Thank you.
How do you feel?
Oh, it's got a tear in my eye.
Yeah.
So hard to hold the tears back.
You know, boyfriend, you were all that and a bag of chips.
Welcome to Spain.
Yes.
Thank you. I love you. I love all you guys. And thank you for allowing me to come this far in the competition and your support and everything.
Just keep
love
going,
guys,
man.
Literally.
Just keep going. You've got a taste of it now. You smash that. You know what it's like to, like, own it. Just keep doing that.
Absolutely. Now, Isaac, in the crowd, you have a huge fan club, including your mum, Natasha. Natasha, how proud are you tonight?
Fantastic. Oh, I should speak in the microphone, shouldn't I? I'm just so overwhelmed right now. Like, we've got the whole family here. We've got brother, we've got sister, we've got girlfriend, best mate, mum, we've got mother-in-law, dad, pop.
The whole family's
auntie,
here.
Auntie, brother.
Amazing.
We've got everybody.
Thank you for coming. Wow, we can't wait to see you perform again next week, Isaac. Please head on over to the lounge and
thank
celebrate with everyone else and give it up one more time for Isaac, everybody.
Oh, how good was that? Well, we're over the halfway mark. Four singers down, three to go. Then we're going to find out who's going through to next week's live shows. Isaac, come and join me. Well done, mate. You can relax now. That's the good news. But the bad news for you guys at home, good singers will be going home. So up next on Transformation Week, it is Ivana. She's a 20-year-old. Listen to the cheers from a proud Serbian family with four protective brothers. Can she bring the party to the stage with a David Guetta dance floor banger? Her must-see makeover and performance is next on Idol. Australian Idol, where it's been a big night, but it's about to get a whole lot bigger because I'm here with Ivana's family and they roll with a lot of numbers. But I mean, I've got the boss of the family. This is Matea. Matea, are you having fun tonight?
Yes.
You are? Okay. Yeah. How did you feel after your sister smashed her audition? You went to school. What was everyone saying at school?
Well, they kind of said, I saw your sister on TV.
Yeah.
And that's pretty much it.
Did you become a celebrity at school?
Not really.
Not really?
Nah, but I don't know. If she wins it, then I might.
I think so. I think if she smashes it tonight on stage, she'll become a big celebrity at your school.
Yeah, definitely. I hope she smashes it and...
I can't wait to see it. Well, guess what? I'm going to get you right now to what we call throw to your sister. So if you look down that camera and you say, Australian Idol, this is Ivana.
Australian Idol, this is Ivana.
Yeah.
You've got an incredible voice, no doubt.
You've got a mental voice.
I like your voice. I think you did a very good job.
Sounded very sexy.
Yeah, she has got a very sexy voice.
I think having the judges compliment me and say that I have, you know, a great voice is just, it's something else. Like, it's just so big coming from them. Oh, well, I nearly tripped out. Oh my God. Hi, oh my Lord. Oh my God. Oh. Whoa, that's loud. How are you,
That's
good?
Your voice.
I'm singing Remember by Becky Hill and David Guetta.
Okay, so talk to me about movement and stuff like that.
I have to be moving around, showing that I can be the total package. I don't dance, but I'm also very clumsy. I won the most clumsy award at my school in year 12. So I got an award at formal and I won it, so. Oh, God.
You got it.
Okay.
Just trying to find a way that the hip just naturally comes in and it's not like 5, 6, 7, 8, and then you do the choreography.
Okay.
Yeah, 3 steps.
I'm sorry, I can't dance.
Yeah,
you can,
right,
you can.
That's
okay.
Exactly.
It's just like the little icing on top.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. 3, 2, 1, and walk, 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 stay, stay. Occasionally I lose composure. If I could go back. This performance has a lot riding on it. so much pressure. It's my last chance to show the judges everything I've got. I just got to get out of my head and just really just go out there and show them who I can be and just perform. I can do that, that's fine. Just...
hoping to level up her performance with some brand new moves to match her brand new look, with her proud Serbian family cheering on, singing one of the biggest hits of this decade, Remember by David Guetta.
I'm doing just fine now it's over. I've been moving on and living my life. But occasionally I lose composure and I can't get you out of my mind. If I could go back in time, I'd do things differently. Yeah, I wouldn't think twice. I'd distract myself, think of someone else.
Yeah, I'm feeling you with that sigh of relief, you know. That was big. That was big. I'm glad you brought some dance, you know, to the show because...
Thank you.
You're welcome. You're welcome. You know, I heard you had some pitch problems, you know, and it's really difficult if you're not used to hearing yourself in your in-ears. I heard that in rehearsal. You went, oh, damn, that's big.
Right? Yeah, very loud.
Yeah, it's very loud, isn't it? You know, and so I don't know if you're being taught this, but... when I use my in-ears, I never use two. I always pop one out because I want to hear about the ambience of the audience. I want to hear about what, if I'm pitching right, and if I'm pitching properly with the singers and the band. So that's my little sort of like a bit of advice to you.
Girlfriend, thank you.
You look fabulous. I love the hair.
Thank you. It's down, no, finally out.
Yeah. You look great. You did great.
Thank you.
You're
thank
welcome, you. Honey.
That's exactly what you're supposed to do. You came it, you smashed it, you look $1 million. I felt like I was at a real concert.
Thank you.
I forgot for a second I was here because I was really into it and I was looking for, like, is she as good as she seems? So you have to really listen in here. And, I just thought it was, I was at a paid show, forgot I was judging. So you nailed it.
Oh, my God. Thank you so much.
Yeah, I feel exactly the same. There's a very small handful of people in this show now that I just don't get, I don't get nervous for, and you're one of them, Ivana. You come out on stage and I'm like, she's got, from the second you start singing, I'm just like, I'm at a show right now, yeah. And I'm just going to enjoy Ivana because you just always bring it. You've got your voice there, you've always got everything happening, and I'm just always in awe of you.
Thank you so much.
Well done. God. Ivana, what a voice!
Hello.
What a performance! How was that for you?
Honestly, for me, I think being able to just go out there and do that, I'm not used to doing so much movement and so much actual performing, but that felt absolutely incredible. Like, oh my God, it's just all I want to do.
It sounded amazing. Do. You look amazing.
Thank you.
Wow, I love that. We're going to have to wait, though, for the judge's decision to see if that performance was enough to get you into the top 12. Please, one more time, everybody, give it up for Ivana.
Thank you.
limited spots in the top 12 available. Our next performer knows it's all or nothing. He's the raspy-voiced tradie who became a new dad literally just days ago, and now he's backstage and keen to show he can balance fresh fatherhood with the intense idol competition. Jackson from Werribee, Victoria, performs next. Don't go anywhere. Is on the line, and only the best of the best will make it to the top 12 live shows. Now, with Judge Amy giving Isaac his fast pass, it means there's only three spots left. Ooh. It's Transformation Week, and there is no greater transformation than parenthood, right, Kyle?
Oh, yeah, that really sneaks up and grabs you. That
changes things a bit.
Yeah, I understand why people have their kids in their 20s, because they're exhausting these kids.
They're always around, crying.
They never go home.
And you have to change them.
I know. It's joyous. It is beautiful. I can't believe he's just had a kid in the last...
I know, it's crazy. Australia, check out this adorable photo of Kyle and his son, Baby Otto. Oh, my God.
He got his mother. He looks, thank the Lord.
I think he looks exactly like you.
Yeah, he does.
He's got a big head like me.
He looks exactly like you. How's dad life treating you?
He is the most wonderful thing that's ever happened to me. Yeah, he is lovely. Yeah, he is.
Who even are you? This big, soft teddy bear. I don't even know who you are.
I'm Caramello Koala. He's got the koala vibe thing going. Yeah, it's great.
He's
when are
adorable.
You having a couple?
Oh, not me. Not for me, no
oh,
thanks.
Oh, don't be like that.
They're always around. Well, our next contestant just had a baby boy days ago, and representing his beautiful little family that just got a little bit bigger, it's Jackson.
I can't keep away, babe. I wish that I would forever.
In between top 30 and top 21, I had my baby boy, so baby number two.
How are you feeling?
I'm wrecked. I'm super, super tired. The last couple of days have been a lot for me and the family.
I've had 3 hours sleep. Sleeping just whenever I can, really. If it's on the floor, if it's sitting while holding my little boy, just trying to soak up as much as I can. I'm gonna be singing Hero by Enrique Iglesias. When I first selected the song, it had a completely different meaning to where I am in my life right now.
I was singing it in the point of view of myself, wanting to be a hero for my family, but seeing what my partner did and went through.
Yeah.
She is the true hero.
I need to feel you connect to the lyrics a bit more, because it's just I'm so bloody tired.
Yeah.
Oh, just...
Okay.
There's a lot of mixed emotions going on in this little brain of mine at the moment, just thinking about how much I miss my family. I want to do this to make them proud. I want to do this to make a career and a life out of music for them. I want it more than everyone else.
Just days ago, he welcomed his second child into the world. Will this cute new addition spur him on to take his performance to the next level? Singing the Enrique Iglesias hit with over a billion streams, it's our tradie dad from Melbourne, Jackson!
Would you dance if I asked you to dance? Or would you run and never look back? No, would you cry if you saw me crying? No, would you save my soul tonight? And I can be your hero, baby. And I can kiss away the pain. Breath.
Jackson.
Hey, how are you?
New daddy.
New daddy, yes.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
This is where I think being a judge really confuses me a little bit, because I have a role to play, but I'm also like obviously human. And when I hear your story and I know you're here and you have a newborn at home and you're here and they're there, I just can't even imagine how you're feeling right now. Just the emotions and the lack of sleep, and the fact that you've done that is incredible. But I do have to be a judge.
Yeah, of course.
Because there are people here that really, really want this just as much as you do. Your vocals aren't really there to the level that they need to be. I'm not sure if it was just tonight. I'm not sure if it was just you're tired and there's a lot going on, but we've had some very big performances tonight. So as much as I like you, man, and I'm so happy for you, that just didn't really get to the level that I really wanted it to be at tonight.
No, I appreciate it. And it wasn't because I'm tired. It's not an excuse. I think, yeah, I agree. My vocals were very off. So I really appreciate the honesty. And
it's a good attitude, man. Yeah. That's why we all love you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah. First and foremost, Jackson, you're a gentle soul, you know, and I think you know how you went with that, you know, and I think, you know, what's happening to you in your life is huge, you know, and as you said earlier, you'd like to be attached to what's happening at home. And so somehow, as a performer, I don't know how it's done, but you actually have to split your personality and come and be present here and sort of send the love off to the family. I don't think that your vocal was bad. I just think I know you can do better than that. And I think I'd like you to tell me what you felt about that.
Yeah, holding back emotion a bit.
Well done. Oh, darling.
It's okay, Jackson. Not yet. It's okay.
I just miss my family.
And you're allowed, honey, okay?
I really wanted to come on here and give my best foot forward. And I was given the exact amount of time as everyone else, so.
But they didn't have a baby.
No, I know. Okay. And I didn't either. So
No. Okay, so I'll say it like this, but y'all did, okay? I mean, because it's the emotional struggle for a man and a woman, okay? And the performance that we hoped you would have brought tonight, you weren't able to, and I totally understand and trust you with that.
Yeah.
Okay?
I think I could have obviously given a better performance, but I think I let the emotion of the song, because obviously watching closely my partner giving birth and things not exactly being perfect and thinking that I was a loser and this, and then it's like that hero meaning means so much more to me. And then I think the experience of my vocals, I didn't have enough control to be able to control the emotions and also deliver a really good performance. So yeah, credit to all you guys, because everyone else, you guys, everyone back home deserves to be here. And I think I do deserve to be here. I think my performance tonight didn't show that, and I apologise to you guys for that. But
no apology necessary.
No, not at all.
But yeah, stop. I just... Yeah.
No, don't.
Jackson.
Yeah.
What's heroic that you're probably not realising is it takes quite a man to be able to walk away from that, to go forward, to provide something greater for your family. That's not a bad thing. It's emotional. Like, my kid's at home as well now. But I took a whole week off when we had our child, because I just wanted to be glued there. I can't imagine you having to be in a different state. And do you just want me to put them on a private jet and bring them up tonight? What do you want? What do you need? What do you need? Whatever you need. Like, if it's a financial situation, if it's a care sit, let's just wrap this up and make it happen. I don't want you to suffer. I wouldn't want to suffer. You're too good to go home, but that was rubbish. But you know it.
Agreed.
You know it. Everyone knows it. But we all love you, and I just don't think... Don't. It's hard to work around these emotions.
Yes.
No, of course.
Really hard.
And I appreciate it.
I hope you get through, because I think you got more in the can that we haven't seen.
I do have what it takes. If it wasn't my performance tonight, then, yeah, it definitely will be my next
one. I hope you make it through, man. I do. I really do.
Thank you, guys. I really appreciate it.
Hey,
there they are.
There they are. They're so proud of you. See, they're so proud. I saw you have a moment to yourself, Jackson, when you finished that performance, and I could see that you were disappointed in your performance, but look at their little faces.
Oh, no.
Look how proud they are. You did them so proud.
I love you guys. I'll see you soon.
Oh, that baby should be in bed by now, surely. Our baby should be bedtime. Bedtime. Yeah.
Such a special moment. You did them proud. Go and join the rest of the guys in the lounge. And everybody, give it up one more time.
Thank you,
Jackson.
Okay, last to sing is the girl from the Gold Coast. 19-year-old Saoirse is determined to prove she has what it takes to go all the way. With only four singers going through tonight and the fast pass already handed to Isaac, find out who will get the last three spots. Don't go anywhere, because this is Australian Idol. Week here on Idol, and every one of tonight's singers are desperate to get their hands on a spot in that top 12. I'm here with the Gold Coast crew for our final singer tonight. You're looking pumped up. Now, correct me if I'm wrong, it is Saoirse? Saoirse. What?
Saoirse.
Oh, of course I know what it is. Next up, it is Saoirse.
I think I was swept up in it all.
You really are an incredible talent.
Oh, Saoirse.
Do people get the name Saoirse right? No. Never. Every time I go to my local coffee shop, I use my mum's name. And up until now, I've used that name. So recently, I actually went in and I said,
Saoirse.
Saoirse?
Yes. That's about to make things a whole lot more complicated.
Order for Saoirse.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Have a good
one. A couple of ways my name has been pronounced is Swazi, Saoirse, 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 which is like kind of how it's spelt, so it's a little bit weird. Oh God, sauce. Sometimes once I got rice, just rice.
Well, Dad and I were living in Ireland. We loved the meaning of the name Saoirse. It means freedom in Gaelic.
It has got a beautiful meaning behind it, but they could have changed the spelling, maybe. I can't believe I'm in the top 21. I've gone from the amazing beaches up on the Gold Coast to now playing on my biggest stage yet. In the last solo performance, the judges said that they need to see more.
Great, 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 great every time we see you, but where's the growth? You're already good, but we want great.
I need something that's gonna blow them away. I'm singing Scars to Your Beautiful by Alessia Cara. I think this song is the wow factor for me to show the judges I have what it takes and be vulnerable and be emotional. I want to keep playing these big shows and be on a big stage, and hopefully by the end of it I'll have everyone remembering my name.
She wants you to remember her name and be chanting it all the way to the finals. It's the Gold Coast girl with an Idol glow up, singing a huge top 10 hit, Alessia Cara's Scars to Your Beautiful. This is 19-year-old Saoirse.
Thank you.
She just wants to be beautiful. She goes unnoticed. She knows no limits. She craves attention. She praises an image. She prays to be sculpted by the sculptor. Oh, she don't see the light that's shining deeper than the eyes can find it. Maybe we have made her blind, so she tries to cover up her pain and cut her walls away. 'Cause cover girls don't cry after their face is made. But there's a hope.
Great, great. You're always good. But you know what the problem I have with you is? Not anything to do with the performance. You present yourself beautifully. You're flawless when you perform. But I forget you until every time you come back. And I think, well, why do I keep forgetting this girl?
Yeah.
Because maybe I'm just like, yep, she's good. And I worry about other people. But I don't want you to fade into the distance. There's a lot of people on the show, a lot of great acts. Don't fade away. I don't know, you don't have to be a clown, but you have to do something, like, you know, do you have the same vibe? Or why do I keep forgetting her? She's so good.
I think you are the complete package. You look fantastic.
Thank you.
Sasha, you look fantastic.
Yeah, you look amazing.
Thank you.
But in your performance, you have to find some more hunger. It just doesn't seem like you've got the hunger that's needed. You know, and that's in my humble opinion. I can't speak for these guys, but, you know, and you know you can do this, but you have to push yourself, and I believe that you're not pushing yourself as much. I don't know that you realize how good you could be. So each time you perform, you have to push. Yeah. You have to take it to another level that you didn't even know you could go to.
Yeah.
It's okay? Almost too easy for you. Like.
Yeah, I also think that in this tonight especially, I selfishly wish you did something stripped back, just only because, and you're not to know this, but, you know, we've had Ivana and Amy come out with these big numbers.
Yeah.
And so it's difficult to be, you know, up there. I don't want you to take this in the wrong way, because I'm a Saoirse fan and I love you as an artist. Like,
thank
I would
you.
Buy your albums and I, you know, I hope you do really well. I know you're going to, but, like, I just... Yeah, I just wish you kind of did something stripped back. I still think you have a spot here. It's hard to place you sometimes, you know, and I kind of just wish you did something a little different just to break the noise almost.
Yeah. You know, Saoirse, I just want you to know, but I want what we say was one thing. Can you tell us, talk to us? So
yeah, definitely. Thank you so much for your feedback. I really respect that and I'll definitely take it on board.
Thank you.
So
thank you. Saoirse, you look gorgeous. That was an awesome performance. Doing us GC girls proud. Represent GC.
Yes.
How are you feeling?
I'm feeling pumped. I love that song so much. So I'm really proud of myself. And I definitely think I did it the best I could. I respect all of these guys' feedback. So I'm definitely going to take it on board and hopefully use it in the next round.
All right. Well, you wanted to show a different side. Do you think you managed to do that tonight?
I think I definitely did. I think this song is a little bit vulnerable for me. And I think that I definitely... tapped into that. Well, I think I tapped into it really well. So I hope that came across to you guys and I hope you enjoyed it. Yeah.
Awesome. Well, you did a great job. Go and join the rest of the guys
Thank
over
you.
There in
Thank
the lounge.
You.
Australian Idol, remember her name, it's Saoirse.
All right. Well, we've seen all the performances tonight and now it's time for our judges to make the grueling decision on who will go through to the top 12 and who will be leaving us.
earlier, Isaac was given a fast pass by Amy, which sent him straight into next week's top 12 live shows.
That leaves six singers vying for just three spots. Kyle, Marsha and Amy still have to make the final decision about who has earned a coveted place in the top 12. This is super, super tense.
Yeah, the judges' decision will be final and it will be revealed right after this, so keep it locked on Australian Idol.
You decide the winner of Australian Idol 2024. They'll earn the winning title, joining the ranks of Idol legends before them. Score a recording contract with Sony Music Entertainment Australia and win an epic $100,000 to supercharge their music career.
What an epic prize right there. You are watching Australian Idol. All of our singers have performed and it's time for the judges to make the call on who goes through to next week's huge top 12 live shows.
Last night, the judges chose Imogen, Dylan, Ripley and Drea as the first four singers to make the cut.
And earlier, Amy used her fast pass on Isaac, which shot him directly into the top 12. Congratulations, Isaac. So that means there are just three spots left tonight.
Now the judges have deliberated and it's time for them to reveal their verdict. Amy, who will be joining Isaac to go through to the top 12 tonight?
Okay, I'm going to admit something. I am really nervous right now. This was tough and hard. Tonight was a real challenge for all three of us back there.
Yeah, it was hard.
Okay. So the first person that we are putting through to the top 12 is going to be Amy.
Congratulations, Amy. You have made it into the top 12. How are you feeling right now?
Oh, thank you so much. Thank you so, so much. Oh, thank you.
Oh my goodness.
Well done, Amy. Well, guess what? You get to go and join Isaac over there in the lounge. Congratulations. We'll see you again next week.
That's all right. One safe, two spots to go. It is a tough decision for the judges tonight, but they watched carefully, took everything into account, but unfortunately, not everyone can go through. So, Marsha, who is the judge's next pick?
You know, we want you all to do well. Let's just start by saying that. And we were backstage talking, and your performances were all very, very good, okay? So when you do leave, know that, okay? Please know that. And our choice to go through this evening is Ivana.
Congratulations. What's going through your mind right now?
Oh my God. I don't even know. There's a million things racing in my mind, but thank you so much.
Yeah, oh my God, that's just so surreal.
Well, congratulations. Go celebrate with everyone else.
Thank you. Congratulations.
Okay, the final spot. It is now or never. Do or die. They've all given everything they have to this competition, but who did the judges choose? The final performer going through to the top 12 live shows tonight. Kyle, the verdict please.
This was the one we argued about. The final four here, who is going to be taken through to the top 12? The person going through, the last member tonight to join the top 12, surprisingly to me, is Trent.
Trent, come over here, mate. Trent, congratulations. He's blown away. You have done it. You've made it to the top 12. What's going on in your mind right now?
Oh, mate, I'm speechless. You know, honestly, I can't believe it. You know, with who I'm up against is, you know, they're all great artists and, oh, you know, just got to take it up another notch now, you know, from who's been through, you know, you guys and you two. It's tough, you know, but I just want to thank you guys for giving me the chance and hopefully I can, yeah, and everybody for coming out and, yeah, hopefully this is, yeah.
Trent.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Trent, I know that Marsha and I were talking about this and it really is a chance. It's a chance because you really need to work on your vocals because you were up against some incredible people that are standing next to you on that stage and it was tough, man. So we really do hope that you prove us wrong.
Yep.
Amazing stuff, Trent. Well deserved. Go and join your top 12 contestants over there.
Congratulations to Trent, Ivana, Amy, and Isaac. They are through to the top 12. But unfortunately, this means the Australian Idol clock has run out for Jackson, Natasha, and Saoirse.
Thank you all so much for sharing your talent with us here on Australian Idol and with Australia. It's been an absolute pleasure getting to know you all. Give it up one more time. Jackson, Natasha, and Saoirse.
Well done, guys. Well done. Congratulations.
Congratulations, guys. You did an amazing job. Well, that's it for round two of Transformation Week. Tomorrow night, the action continues with a brand new lineup of singers vying for a place at next week's Idol live shows.
Including Melbourne Muso Jake.
Rockhampton's Yodeling Denver.
Wodonga's Rock Chick Olivia.
Plus TJ, Keani, Tyler, and South Australia's triple threat, Kim.
Who will be our final four contestants to round out our top 12? Find out tomorrow night, 7:30 here on 7.
Thank you so much to our amazing judges, Kyle Sanderlands.
Thank you.